For more information, see the description below. Namaste.
Gum Havamahe Kalim Kavinam Upamashravastamam Jeshtarajam Ramanam Ramanas Patanama Shumvamutindihi Sivasadanam Shri Vakritunda Mahakaya Suryakoti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurunedeva Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada Siddhi Bhuti Shakti Sahitam Shrima Mahamanadipataye Namo Namaha Nirvignam Kuru Om Ganganapataye Namaha. Okay. So we finish Anagatapika. Now we go for page 26, 27. This is going to be 27. So we have what should be
Uhya.
Okay. This is the
where are no 25th.
27.
Hey, this is not completed.
No?
So Sapna is not complete.
Okay. So I did not see this, I only saw this.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. So it's 27. It is Swam. Sajjana.
No. 1 minute, sir. I'll give my card for permission. All that, sir. Okay, so Sapnya, the name itself is giving you that Sosya Sapnya. Sosya Sapnya means the author's terminology. The term that which is created by the author for his textbook. Clear? So you have the right to create a technical term to explain your text, but it should be perfectly known to others. It may not be seen in other textbooks, but you should be able to abbreviate it in or explain it in a proper way. Okay?
So what is the nirukti?
Swasya sapnya swasapnya.
Swasya
sapnya swasapnya. Okay.
Okay.
Now read that line. You can find out. The meaning is very clear. You see. Sa tu.
Okay, here.
Sa tu.
Sa tu ya.
Samnya.
Samnya.
What is the meaning of sa?
Saha.
She.
Okay.
Saha, she.
Okay.
Strilinga.
Strilinga.
Ya, she, who. Correct?
Okay.
Sapnya. Sapnya means terminology, name, term, okay. Term is the meaning. Actually, sapnya means, what are the meanings can be possible for sapnya? Let me see.
He told us expression. Samnya. Would be expression, usage, meaning, interpretation. Some expression of a feature.
Actually, sapnya means name.
Okay.
What is your sapnya? My sapnya is Tyago. Why your sapnya is Tyago? Because with that Tyago, I can identify Tyago.
Okay.
Anything that which is used to identify something, it can be a name.
It can be a form.
Yes. It can be a form.
A number.
Yeah, number. All this through, if I can clearly identify you, then it can be called as
and only
sapnya.
Me.
Even this is sapnya. If I touch you, if you feel that touch, That is also sapnya.
Okay.
Your skin is having the sapnya, that is why you are able to understand my touch.
Okay.
So sensation can be the meaning of sapnya, but here it is not sensation. Here sapnya means a terminology, either in the form of name or in the form of a form or in the form of a name or whatever it may be.
But when Samnya says that
she is
feeling too much hot and she needs to leave, what is the proper meaning for the Samnya there?
Once again?
When Samnya is married with Surya and she's feeling very hot and very bright and she leaves and puts Chaya in her place, what is the proper understanding for Samnya?
Very See, if you are the real knowledge, real sensation in you,
okay,
to experience the power of the sun, what will happen? You will try to bear it. When you, with your perfect sensation, when you are unable to bear it, immediately what you will do?
Go to the
You will leave that place.
Okay.
Right? And you will make some shadow behind you and in between you and the sun. So Chaya is a character in astrology. Sapnya is another character in astrology.
But there the meaning would be the sensation of Surya. It was overstanding.
Sapnya means the real proper sensation of anything that which can be called Sapnya. If Sapnya is not in a position to bear the influence of other person,
so
he automatically make a Chaya over there and leave the place because he cannot stay.
Shows the idea that Surya sometimes can be very difficult to bear.
Yeah, yeah. At that time, what he will do, the Sapnya, what he will do?
Because he burns the papa.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Sapnya, what he will do? He will make a Chaya in between to save herself.
Okay. And from this Chaya, Shani will be born. But this is another part.
Shadow, that is why Shani is called black in color, not very fast in nature, because it is deformality. Chaya is always a deform, less in form.
Okay.
In sound, in color, in nature, in speed, in all qualities.
So if you put a glass between you and the sun will come in a glass. Very interesting.
So I think you got the meaning of sapnya. Here sapnya is a technical terminology in the form of number or in the form of a name or whatever it may be. Okay?
So samnya sa tu ya, and this samnya, okay, this part is done. Samnya swata
swatantreshu swatantreshu plus eva swatantreshu
tra isha
swatantreshu plus eva.
Patantreshu plus Eva.
Hmm.
Okay. This is going to be what? Du. This is D-U. Du.
Drishya. Dr.
It's Dr. Ah.
It is a printing. Okay. Dr. Okay. Will be like this.
Okay. Drishyate.
Yeah. So Sasapnya can be seen only in his touch points.
Okay.
Okay. Because it is created by the other. You cannot see that in other places. You cannot question it because there is a logic in creating that terminology.
So when we are reading about the Chaya, Vridhi and then Kopa, this doesn't appear.
Actually, I told you. Chaya Vriddhi Prabhupada, but actually Chaya Prabhupada Prashamartha Sthiti.
Yeah, but I explained to you
because in between one Vriddhi, because that stage is there where this Chaya is the small accumulation. When the Vriddhi comes, it is in a position that it is very largely finishing and ready to come out.
Yeah,
also you will have the symptoms of disease. But
this is an example of Swasamnya.
Yeah.
Because it's not appearing in Charak or people from the north, they don't speak about it.
Yes. But I am not a book writer. I gave you that Vriddhi by seeing the condition, and Vriddhi is the terminology used by the Ayurvedic scholars. But when you are coming to this, they will tell only Chaya, Chaya, okay. Pragobha and Prashna. They will not mention the term Vriddhi over there. If you notice, you can find out. But Vriddhi, you can see many places, Vriddhi and Chaya you can see.
Okay.
Are you getting my point?
Yes. Okay.
Because, see, a learner, when he is coming, Chaya, Pragobha, Prashna, if he is taking only three, okay?
Okay.
Chaya is the condition where it is slowly accumulating. Vriddhi will be nearer to Pragobha because when the Vriddhi starts, it is towards Pragobha only, leaving the Sthana only.
I was to ask you this in the class. In Kshatriya Kala of Sushruta, we have six stages of Samprapti.
Yeah.
And in your explanation, my understanding was that when you called Prakopa, it was the Prasara and Sthana Samsraya of Sushruta. And then we would have the Veda itself. And
because Prakopa comes, it starts moving towards everywhere in the body. Where it is going to stay, nobody knows. Understood? It spreads. So wherever the suitable Adhishtana gets, that is Sthanasamsraya. It will stay there and it will create the problems. Clear?
Yes.
But if the second stage of Vriddhi is Prakopa. First stage of the Vriddhi is increasing and ready to come out. At that time, if you realize also, you can do the Chikitsa very fast.
Yeah, because in that terminology of six stages, the Chaya would be the Chaya,
yeah.
The Vriddhi would be the Prakopa, and the Prakopa would be the Prasara and the Sthana Samsraya. The point is that it's important to make a differentiation between the dosha accumulation in the Anava, in the Mahavasrotas, and outside, and splitting out.
Chagas, yes. The chagas. You should know it.
Reaching the rasa and going to the chakras.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
So, it can be seen only in the textbook of the author. So, right. So, Satnya.
Mm-hmm.
So, Satnya either can be a name or a term or a number. Or a principle created by the author, which can be seen only in that science but not in other sciences of that time. Clear? Clear for you? So Satnya is Trilinga, that's why Saya, etc. they are using. In English, when it comes, it will be automatically in Notalinga.
So for example, in Portuguese, they use the word unbalanced doshas. Okay? And I'm saying to my students, from now on, we are going to understand Vata, Pitta, Kapha and Dosha only with the word disturbed.
Yeah.
If I say unbalanced, it can be in a healthy state that Vata, Pitta and Kapha are moving. They are not stable, they are not rigid. They are unbalanced, but just like the cycle is... when you're riding a bicycle, you're in a constant unbalancing stage, but you're not falling off. So when you are falling off, it's going to be disturbed. And I'm saying, this is my terminology. This is not a terminology that you are.
It is there in Ayurveda.
Correct.
It's
a kind of...
That is so. Correct.
Okay.
But you should be able to logically give the clear interpretation of your terminology.
Yes.
Clear on
it. I do this a lot.
Because that is required for understanding.
I feel that the terminology in Ayurveda, they are overlapping and they are
true.
They are being confused because some people say one thing and other people say another thing. So I say, I'm going to be saying
correct,
this
correct,
and
correct,
this
correct, man. Correct. You are right.
So this is, do we need to say anything more about this, or we go for 28?
No, go to the example. One example must
one
be.
One example, at least, Tiago. Don't be so lazy. Let's go. Shaka. Rakta.
Shaka.
Shaka.
Rakta. Dayastvak.
Rakta. Dayastvak.
I like this one. Tuk. Sloga is.
Cha.
Loganam Padaniyam chapter. Fourth chapter. No, it is in 12th chapter. Sutra. Ashtangardaya Sutra. 12th chapter, 44th sloka, right?
Okay.
Correct?
Yes.
Number is right. Whatever I told
is
right.
This one is very
one, many places, many places, they will write many type of printing.
Okay.
So all printing problem. Mm-hmm.
Okay, no problem. But the point is that it's going to be Dosha Veda.
Okay, yes, Dosha Veda. Right. Correct one.
These ones are already known. So, he's explained that Shaka means Saptadhatu and Tvak against the popular meaning of branches.
Yes, yes, branches. Correct one.
Iti Samja Samjita.
Iti Sapnita.
Sam, it's not Swa.
It is Samnitaha. Samnitaha.
Samnitaha.
Is named, is termed.
Okay.
Yadyevam.
Yadyevam.
Sneha.
This is Sneha. Okay.
Sneha Klinnaha.
Sneha.
Klinnaha.
Klinnaha. Okay.
Koshtaha.
Koshta. Koshtaga.
Koshtaga, correct. Koshtaga. Ityadi.
Ityavi. Ityavi pra o gra.
Ityadi grantai.
Grante.
Shaka.
Shaka. Kidya. Ki.
Ki, correct. Kim, is there no?
Is there? Okay,
Kim.
Is there? Okay, put the Kim. No problem.
Vyavadesha. Kim Vyavadesha.
Kim
Vyavadesha.
Kim Vyavadesha. Tatra. Shaka. Parnipa.
Parnipadaha.
Da. Okay. Parnipadaha.
Not over. Sira.
Sira. Vibha.
Sira.
Vibhaga.
Vibhagetu.
Vibhagetu. Vibhagetu. Tatram. Kam. Ka.
Tandregatra.
Tatregatra. Tatra.
Tatregatra. Shagayam Satam.
Okay.
That means Shaka, the term, is used in many places with many ideas. Some places Panipada, like this they have given. Like this there are 100 Shakas. But when you are coming to the first terminology, where he is using the term Shaka, but it is not which one? That Shaka.
Okay.
Okay, what is that Shaka then?
Here he said it was Dhatus and
Yes. So like these terms are used by the author to mention that place because of the action related.
Because the Dhatus and the Tvak are not the Anavaha or the Mahavajrota. Yes.
So he used it as Shaka. I hope you understood now. Clear? Clear? It is so sapnya. You cannot see that Shaka. Somewhere else, if you go the Shaka terminology, if you see, they would have given some other.
So for Ayurveda, the trunk of the body is the
yes.
Mahavahisrotas.
Yes.
And the branches are the Shakas. The Dhatus and the Tvak, they are not going to be the trunk.
Yes. It's I hope you understood now.
Yes.
So sapnya. To that context, a term is used by the author. It should not be confused as the prasiddha sapnya. Clear? Prasiddha okay. Sapnya means the sapnya accepted by all sciences. Clear?
Okay.